How do I keep myself inspired every single day to achieve the goals that I've set in my life? Does eating small meals every few hours in a day, does it really help in maintaining weight? And how do you manage overwhelmingness or a sense of self-guilt when you're not able to accomplish the tasks that you want to accomplish in any typical day? These are the questions that are going to be answered in today's 10th episode of Relentless Talk with Amit. I'm very excited to answer these questions. If you are excited as well to listen to the answers, then make sure you tune into this episode and watch this episode till the very last second. Namaste, Sat Sri Akal, Salaam Alaikum, Jai Hind to all of you. I welcome you to the 10th episode of Relentless Talk with Amit. Just like every single episode, in this episode also, we are going to answer 3 questions. So let's start very quickly. Chetali, what's the first question that we have for today?
So this first question is from Keshav, from Ahmedabad to WhatsApp. He's asking that how to keep myself inspired every single day to achieve my goals, as I really struggle to keep myself motivated over a period of time.
Okay, so Keshav, let's understand, how do you keep yourself inspired every single day? See, ये जो चीज़ है, inspiration every single day is something that I have also struggled in my life. In fact, ये ऐसी चीज़ है which a lot of people struggle to remain inspired every single day. अगर आप एक question पूछोगे generally to a lot of people out there, to a lot of successful people, if you listen to a lot of YouTube videos, a lot of stuff from various successful people, you will get to hear stuff like, for you to remain inspired every single day of your life, you need to have a big enough vision for yourself. You need to have a big enough reason for yourself, a big enough reason, a big enough vision, a big enough mission in your life. Something that can wake you up every day from your bed and can push you to get things done. This is the kind of answer that you're going to get from a lot of people. Now, I'm going to speak about something that I think, how do you remain inspired every single day according to my point of view. It is up to you whether it makes sense to you what I'm going to say, or whether it makes sense to you, or what others are going to say about remaining inspired. So listen to my answer very, very carefully. See, if you have a vision in your life, if you have a big enough reason in your life, a so-called mission in your life, for you to remain inspired every single day, suppose you achieve your vision, suppose you achieve your mission, then what? Are you not going to remain inspired after that? Now another question will come. After that, you create another vision. You create another reason for you to move towards in your life. If you achieve that also, after that again you are going to create another mission, another something, a big enough reason. I don't think so. That is the best way for you to remain inspired as a human being every single day. What is the real answer for us to remain inspired every single day? By the way, why do we need to remain inspired every single day for us to achieve goals in life? Is being a human being itself, having a human life itself, is that not a big enough reason, a big enough vision, so-called vision, a big enough mission for us to remain inspired every single day? Being a human, is that not a privileged life? Out of all the creatures, human life is the most privileged life. Why do you say that? इसलिए नहीं बोलता because we are dominating the planet. इसलिए बोलता because we are just like any other creature on this planet. The only difference is that we have this buddhi. We have this brain, we have this mind, which is more advanced compared to other creatures, because of which we are dominating this planet. और अगर हमारे पास इतनी privileged life है, तो क्या हमें कोई और so-called reason चाहिए for us to remain inspired, to achieve our goals in life? क्या हमें so-called vision चाहिए? क्या हमें so-called mission चाहिए? Is having a human life itself, is that not a big enough reason for us to live our life every single moment in the best possible way, remain happy? Because when you're happy, when you're living every single moment of your life at the best moment, precious moment of your life, you are going to be happy. When you're happy, are you not going to automatically, by default, inspire to achieve whatever you want to achieve? Because a happy person is going to not need any outside reason. Essentially, most of the human beings are looking for a outside reason, are looking for a reason on the periphery, on the outer surface, for them to remain inspired in life. If I do this, if I have this vision, then I'm going to remain inspired. I want to impact this country. I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to become a billionaire. This is my big enough reason. No, being a human itself, having a human life itself is a big enough reason for us to remain inspired. ये थोड़ा deep answer है, but according to me, this is the right answer as human beings. मैं आपको वो answer नहीं दूंगा जो just because a lot of people are going to say this is the answer that I should also say. No, according to me, according to my buddhi, being a human being, living every single moment to the best possible ability, living every single moment is a precious moment, being happy in every single moment is a big enough reason for me to remain inspired. हर एक लाइफ का जो सेकंड हमें मिला है ना, इतना प्रेशियस है, पर ये भूल जाते हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि हम बाकियों की तरह लाइफ जी रहे हैं, भाग रहे हैं, रेस लगा रहे हैं दुनिया से. जब तक ये अंदरूनी ज्ञान नहीं आएगा ना हमें अपने बारे में, ये अंदरूनी मेंटल टफनेस नहीं आएगी ना, तब तक हम लाइफ में कितने भी रीजन निकाले, वी आर ऑलवेज गोइंग टू फॉल शॉर्ट ऑफ द इंस्पिरेशन दैट वी नीड फॉर अस टू लिव एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग. द ओनली इंस्पिरेशन दैट यू नीड फॉर यू टू लिव एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग टू अचीव योर गोल्स इन लाइफ is being a human being and living this life every single moment. Having this life to be able to live is a big enough reason for you to remain inspired. It is not going to happen in a day. It will take time for you to implement this. But yehi cheez aapko samajhni padegi. Aaj jo bhi aapki age hai, ye baat agar samajh ke ki life hona hi ek big enough reason hai for me to remain inspired. Jab aap life ki importance, life ki ahmiyat samajhna start kar denge, उस सेकंड की, उस मिनट की, उस घंटे की अहमियत स्टार्ट कर देंगे समझना, तब हमें कोई और आउटर सरफेस से, आउटर पेरिफेरी से कोई रीजन नहीं चाहिए टू रिमेन इंस्पायर्ड. एंड देन यू विल बी हैप्पी, एंड व्हेन यू आर हैप्पी देन यू विल डू एवरीथिंग पॉसिबल टू बी एबल टू अचीव योर गोल्स. यू विल नॉट प्रोक्रेस्टिनेट, यू विल नॉट ओवरथिंक, यू विल गेट थिंग्स डन. दैट विल बी माय आंसर टू योर क्वेश्चन. आई होप दैट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प. सो लेट्स मूव टू द सेकंड क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव फॉर टुडे. चेताली,
सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम आदित्य फ्रॉम लखनऊ टू फेसबुक. He's asking that I'm trying to maintain my weight at a current level, and I have heard many people saying that you should eat small meals every 2 hours to do the same. How does that really help?
It does not really help. मैंने भी जब मैंने बॉडी बिल्डिंग स्टार्ट करी थी, या जब मैंने अपनी फिटनेस में अपना फिटनेस स्टार्ट करी थी अपनी लाइफ में, तब मेरे मैंने भी बहुत सुना था कि हर 2-2 घंटे में खाना खाओ, हर 3-3 घंटे में खाना खाओ, अपने डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, अपने मेटाबॉलिज्म को हाई रखो. इट इज रियली गोइंग टू हेल्प यू टू मेंटेन वेट, इट इज रियली गोइंग टू हेल्प यू टू लूज वेट ऑल्सो, इट इज रियली गोइंग टू हेल्प टू बिल्ड मसल्स. ये जो चीज़ है ना, विद ऑल रिस्पेक्ट टू एवरीबडी ऑन दिस प्लेनेट, एवरी रीजन ऑन दिस प्लेनेट, ये चीज़ है, इट हैज कम फ्रॉम द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड, नथिंग अगेंस्ट द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड, बट जस्ट बिकॉज हमने ये सुन ली है, हमने इस पर विश्वास कर लिया, बिल्कुल भी नहीं. मैं आपको लॉजिकल रीजन देता हूँ, और आपको अगर समझ में आए तो आप मुझे बताइए कि डज दैट मेक सेंस और नॉट. ये 2-2 घंटे में खाना खाने की जो प्रथा, जो हमें चीज सिखाई गई है, आप मुझे बाबत, आप 2-2 घंटे में अगर खाना खाते रहो, आप अपने डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, ये जो खाना होता है इज गेटिंग डाइजेस्टेड थ्रू आवर डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, आपके डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम को टाइम ही नहीं मिल रहा उस खाने को पचाने का. आप भरे जा रहे हो हर 2 घंटे में, हर 3 घंटे में, कुछ ना कुछ, चाहे छोटा बड़ा, छोटा कुछ ना कुछ खाए जा रहे हो. आप अपने डाइजेस्ट सिस्टम को 24 घंटे काम पे लगा रखे, 24/7 काम पे लगा रखे, तो कहां से आप मेंटेन वेट कर पाओगे, कुछ कर पाओगे? क्योंकि आप अगर 24 घंटे मशीन जो अंदर डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम है उस मशीन को काम पे लगा रखा है, तो वो जो मशीन की एफिशिएंसी है ना टू एक्चुअली डाइजेस्ट द फूड प्रॉपरली एफिशिएंटली इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी देयर. इसलिए लोगों का जो अंदर खाना होता है वो फैट बन जाता है, फैट की परत बन जाती है, जिसकी वजह से ओबेसिटी होती है. इसलिए वो खाना अंदर जर्म्स, टॉक्सिंस, बैक्टीरिया पैदा करता है, जिसकी वजह से इलनेसेस होती है, लाइक बीपी, लाइक ब्लड प्रेशर, लाइक एस्थमा, लाइक नी पेन, लाइक जॉइंट पेन. हम अब एक मशीन को आप सोच देखो, अगर आपकी गाड़ी है, आपके पास 2-व्हीलर है, आपके पास 4-व्हीलर है, आप उस 2-व्हीलर 4-व्हीलर की कोई मेंटेनेंस नहीं कर रहे, 24 घंटे चलाए जा रहे काम पर लगा रखा है, तो कहां से उसकी एफिशिएंसी मेंटेन रहेगी, कहां से उसकी प्रोडक्टिविटी मेंटेन रहेगी? उसकी एफिशिएंसी, उसकी प्रोडक्टिविटी तभी मेंटेन हो पाएगी जब आप उसकी रेगुलर मेंटेनेंस करो. सिमिलरली हमारी बॉडी भी एक मशीन है, और उस मशीन में डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम एक कॉम्पोनेंट है, एक पार्ट है ऑफ दैट मशीन. उस मशीन को एफिशिएंटली चलाने के लिए आपको रेगुलरली 2-2 घंटे में खाना खाना, इनफैक्ट यू शुड कीप अ गैप ऑफ 5-6 आवर्स मिनिमम बिटवीन योर मील्स, मिनिमम टू मिनिमम. और उसके लिए यू शुड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थिंक अबाउट ईटिंग जस्ट 2 मील्स इन अ डे. चाहे आप मेंटेन करना चाहते हो वेट, इवन इफ यू वांट टू बिल्ड मसल्स, इवन इफ यू वांट टू लूज वेट, इन एनी केस मोस्ट पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड अडॉप्टिंग ब्रेकफास्ट लंच डिनर. ब्रेकफास्ट लंच डिनर 3-3 मील खाना, अगेन इट हैज कम फ्रॉम द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड. 3 टाइप की मील, ब्रेकफास्ट भी करो, लंच भी करो, डिनर भी करो. Today, if you ask me, I just have 1 meal a day. Just 1 meal a day. And that helps me to maintain weight. That helps me to even build muscle. If I want to build more, I can build more by just being on 1 meal a day. There is a way to do that. But I cannot give you a meal plan right now, but हमारे पूर्वज में, हमारे पुराने भारत में लोग एक एक मील पे रहते थे, और उसकी वजह से ये नहीं कि वो कमजोर पड़ जाते थे, ये नहीं कि कुछ ताकत नहीं थी, ये नहीं स्ट्रेंथ नहीं थी. टुडे इफ यू वांट टू मेंटेन वेट, इंस्टेड ऑफ आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू से टू गो टू वन मील फ्रॉम थ्री मील्स, एटलीस्ट गो फॉर टू मील्स, हैव वन मील अराउंड 10:30 11 o'clock इन द मॉर्निंग इफ यू वांट टू, एंड हैव अनदर मील अराउंड 4:30. कीप अ गैप ऑफ 5 आवर्स बिटवीन योर टू मील्स. And eat the right kind of food, which you need to learn what is the right kind of food for you to be able to maintain weight. But ये जो ये चीज है ना कि दो-दो घंटे में खाना खाना चाहिए for you to maintain weight, for you to keep your metabolism high, running high, is a myth. It is not going to help you in any way because अपनी body को, अपने digestive system को हमें time देना चाहिए for us to be able to digest the food. एक रोटी पचाने में 6 से 8 घंटा लगता है. और अगर आप हर 2-2 घंटे में कुछ खाते रहोगे तो आप ही सोचो कि किस तरीके से वो मशीन efficiently काम करेगा. So I hope my answer helps you. Let's move to the third question that we have today. So Chitali, what's the third question?
So this question is from Manoj from Kolkata through WhatsApp. He's saying that they say you need to be proactive in life to be successful, but sometimes being proactive with everything leads to overwhelmingness and I end up not accomplishing my task, which leads to guilt. How do I handle this?
So jab aap proactiveness ki baat kar rahe ho, I am assuming कि आप बात कर रहे हो that I am thinking of, I am planning of the tasks, the goals that I want to achieve in a day, in a week, in a year. So I am being proactive in creating my task for a day, in creating let's say my outcomes for a day. But कहीं ना कहीं मेरी वो proactiveness जो होती है कि मुझे ये करना है, ये करना है, ये करना है, ये करना है, is leading to overwhelmingness, which is leading to a sense of guilt when I'm not able to accomplish those tasks. If you want to handle this, the very first thing that you need to understand is stop becoming a victim to your own story in life. What does it mean? We have created a story proactively that I need to do this, I need to do this, I need to do this, I need to do this. मुझे ये 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 करना है. मेरे पास 5 चीजें, 6 चीजें, 10 चीजें, 15 चीजें दिन में लगा दी अपने दिमाग में. We create a story. और जब वो अकम्प्लिश नहीं हो पाती है, क्या पता मैं ओवन हो रहा हूँ चीजों को लेके, और जब अकम्प्लिश नहीं होती है तो मेरे अंदर सेल्फ गिल्ट होता है, और वो सेल्फ गिल्ट इज एक्चुअली नॉट हेल्पिंग मी टू बी एबल टू इवन अकम्प्लिश अ थिंग दैट आई रियली वांट टू अकम्प्लिश. तो पहली चीज तो आपको ये समझनी पड़ेगी कि वी नीड टू स्टॉप बिकमिंग अ विक्टिम टू आवर ओन स्टोरी. जो हमने स्टोरी बना के रखी ना, ये करना, ये करना, ये करना, ये करना, ये करना, हो नहीं रहा. स्टॉप बिकमिंग अ विक्टिम टू योर ओन स्टोरी, फर्स्ट थिंग. सेकंड थिंग, इफ यू आर गेटिंग ओवरवेल्म्ड, which is leading to a sense of guilt because things are not getting accomplished, ask yourself, ye overness kyun aa rahi hai? Are you really overestimating the things that you can do in any typical day? Jab aap proactive ho rahe ho aur apne dimag mein cheeze bana rahe ho ki mujhe ye karna hai, ye karna hai, ye karna hai, and that is leading to overwhelmingness, maybe you are overestimating the number of tasks that you can do on a typical day. Ask yourself, why am I not able to accomplish these things? Why am I not able to? Am I overestimating? Am I not being efficient enough? Am I not being productive enough? Am I not utilizing my time properly? Because of which I end up not doing the task. Ask yourself this question. And the third thing is, ये जो self-guilt होता है, जो self-sabotage होता है, it is never going to help you. जितना आप self-guilt में रहोगे ना, कि मैंने कुछ सोचा कि मुझे ये accomplish करना है और मैं नहीं कर पा रहा, आप मुझे खुद बताओ कि जो self-guilt है, ये self-guilt, is that helping you to actually change the equation and actually figure out a way to get those things done? No. ये self-guilt आपको एक loop में रख रहा है. आप self-guilt करते हो, self-sabotage करते हो. When you are into self-guilt mode, when you are into self-sabotage mode, you are focusing on what you are not doing, why you are failing. You are focusing essentially on the problem. You are not able to put your focus on the solution. Okay, if something is not happening, why is it not happening? What are the gaps? Where do I need to fill those gaps? What do I need to do new? You're not been able to focus on the solution part of it because of self-guilt. There's a difference between keeping yourself accountable when you're not accomplishing what you want to accomplish and going into self-guilt mode. Accountability means you look at, okay, I thought of doing these things proactively and it is not happening. What's the reason? Let me figure out a reason. Let me see what can I improve and let me get those improvements done for me to do those things. That is accountability. You're not putting too much focus on the problem. But self-guilt, self-sabotage, leads you to focus only on the problem, and that is only going to keep you in the loop. So my answer to your question is, you got to first of all stop becoming a victim to your own story that I need to do this, I need to do this, and if I'm not able to accomplish, you beat yourself up. Stop becoming a victim to your own story. Ask yourself if some things are not being accomplished in a particular day by being proactive, where am I lacking? What are the improvement areas? Where can I improve? What do I need to change? What is the new input that I need to put? How do I improve my efficiency? How do I improve my productivity? Whatever it takes for you to get those things done. And the third thing is, this self-guilt loop is never going to help you. So move out of self-guilt, keep yourself accountable, and only focus on the solution. So I hope that is going to help you, Manoj. With this, we have come to the end of this 10th episode of Relentless Talk with Avneet. I hope ये जो answers आप सुन रहे हैं आपको help कर रहे हैं in various areas of your life. My intent always has been to give you as to how your mindset, how your mental toughness can help you to achieve everything. So I hope these answers are helping you. If you have a question as well, please put out your question to me on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, wherever, all the social media channels. Also put out your question to me on my office WhatsApp number, which is displayed on the screen. And your question might get picked, maybe next week, maybe next to next week. So keep answering those questions. And I'm going to see you in the next week of 11th episode of Relentless Talk with Avneet.